video, I started it mainly for myself so I'd remember how to do something, but hopefully it will help other people with this. We wanted to see how to do blur effects using this version of Adobe Premiere 3.0. So, the first thing you're going to do is import a video that you want to work with. So, I'll import one. Drag the video down here to video 1. Now you want to have a copy of it in video 2, which is what we're going to be editing. So one of the effects we're going to want to use here is Mosaic. And this is under Video Effects Stylized Mosaic in this particular version. So I'm going to go on video 2 to apply it. Now you can see it's already blurred out that video. So we're going to expand the mosaic, change the number, we're going to increase this number. So as we increase the number, the blur is not as bad. Now if we have it too high of a number, it's going to be quite visible, which may not be what you want. So you'll find a number that's going to work for you, that you're happy with, and stick with that. Now it's blurring the whole thing. So what we're going to want to do is go to File, New, Title, and whatever name, Blur Face. Brings up this window, choose a tool that you want to use, and cover that area. Now if you want, if you have a little bit of movement going on here, you can cover the whole area if you want. And then just okay that or close it. Now the other part of this is to link these two together, so the video, so it knows to use the blur face. So we're gonna that title, so I'll put that in here and expand it so it's in there. But it's just a white box. So we need to do track mat key, which we can search this way. And we're going to throw that onto video 2. Go in the effects of track mat key. And for the mat, we're going to choose video 3, which is where our title is. And there it is, you can see the effect is already on there. As we go through the video, you can see it's blurred the face throughout the entire video. And that's basically it. Now, there's ways of tracking movement in that, which here there's not a lot of movement, so it's not like someone walking in a video where you want to track it from one position to another. It pretty much stays the same throughout the entire video, as you can see. Except for certain parts, like over here, at some point I'm moving right off right outside of the thing. So over here, so what I'll do is just resize this, and at some point over here is where it starts to go over to the left more. So I'm just gonna bring in another copy of the title, slap that in place there, expand that, and then for that particular one, the motion, I can go into position. Now I can just simply click and drag it over, and that's it. So on this track, the blur is more to the right, and as we go into this part of it, it's more to the left, so you can see that it's moving with it as I need it. And that's about it. This is very basic. You can spend more time on it to make it perfect, but that's, I think you get the idea. Alright, that's it for this tip. Let me know what you think. Post your comments, rate my video please, subscribe to it so you can see when new videos are uploaded. You won't know about the new ones unless you're subscribed. and let me know what else you'd like to learn. I'd love to put on as many videos as possible. I just sometimes need some help with the ideas of what you guys actually want to see. So let me know. Thanks for viewing, and talk to you again soon. Thanks. Bye for now.